We're now going to extend the topic of ANOVA to two-factor ANOVAs. I have very mixed emotions about even taking on this topic because it's complicated and fraught with problems, but I decided that there's enough times where people use this approach that it's worth at least introducing, even if it's not necessarily practical for you to carry out without professional help. One of the reasons why two-factor ANOVA is such a minefield is that there are so many different variants. You have kinds with fixed effects and random effects, which we'll talk about. Mixed models, there are also nested ANOVAs, repeated measures ANOVAs, and there are three different ways of calculating the ANOVAs. The end result is that depending on what kind of software package you use, you sometimes get different results for the very same test because of disagreements among statisticians about how the statistics should be calculated. There are also some statisticians who have real problems with using these tests for hypothesis testing, that is, for calculating and assessing P under certain circumstances. And also, now that other more complex methods have been developed, a lot of statisticians believe that they're just simply better alternatives than some of these two-factor ANOVAs. Nevertheless, you do see people doing two-factor ANOVAs, and under the circumstances where you have a relatively simple design, and particularly if you have a balanced design, that is a situation where each one of your groups within the analysis has the same sample size, then there are less likely to be problems and it's a little bit safer to use the two-factor ANOVA.